It's my I'm thankful for your invitation and to give me the opportunity to answer some of, as factually as I can, some of these allegations.
All right. Okay. Well, we're supposed to talk about many other issues that the DOH is supposed to be doing in the next few days. But let's start with this. Headline of the Inquirer today, conflict of interest allegations, your family's a corporation, Doctors Pharmaceuticals. Lacson said two of the supply contracts that were bagged by your family's corporation lasted until October 2017. Let's start with that.
Well, number one,
what was your role in the firm?
In the firm, I divested since 2006. So I had nothing to do with all of these contracts since 2006. Kasi alam ko, when I was first appointed by GMA in 2005 up to 2010 as Secretary of Health, ang inisip namin, magkakaroon ng conflict of interest because I was a shareholder of the Doctors Pharmaceutical Incorporated, which was already owned by the family as far back as mid-1990s.
Okay.
So it was already actually bidding. So it's not as if it just started bidding during my time.
Yeah.
In
fact,
during my time, pinahinto ko nga. Kasi nga, sabi ko ganun, magkakaroon ng conflict of interest, but in spite of the fact that I divested. I told my brother, pwede ba, wag na kayo mag-bidding dyan.
Panahon pa to ni GMA.
Yes, panahon pa ni GMA.
Okay.
So, anyway, ang sinasabi ni doon sa Inquirer nga, na ito daw contract, I think, they were referring to 2014 up to 2015, na 23 million pesos worth with PITC. PITC, or the Philippine International Trading Corporation, meron siyang procuring arm for medicines. This is the PITC Pharma. I think you know that. Ano? Okay. So, 23 million, but I will have to validate that. I will have to ask our director of Doctors Pharma, is this true, yung 23 million? Because when I actually asked her last night, although, syempre, you know, I was also talking to Inquirer, medyo sabi niya, sir, hindi yung totoo yan, 23 million. Nabawasan ho yan. Pero iti-check daw niya. She needs to verify for herself. So, anyway, I will have to find that out today kung magkano talaga yung amount. And then, ang sabi sa Inquirer, pina-recall daw ni former Secretary Garin yung 23 million worth of antibiotics or amoxicillin. Ngayon, because hindi daw siya angkop doon sa good manufacturing practice. So in other words, may question sa standards of safety, quality. So, pinabalik. And that is not uncommon. Dahil talagang may mga gamot na bago mo tanggapin, papatest mo. At kung nakita mong may problema, pare-recall mo. But then, of course, sasabihin mo din doon sa supplier na kailangan merong kang deficiencies. And how are you going to address those deficiencies? At kung na-address mo yung deficiencies, pwede ka na ulit mag-bid. Kasi na-address mo yung deficiency. And that's the process. It's not as if parang it's a process na ginawa lang just by or for accommodation.
Okay, but let's first show. You said you have documents showing you divested. Let's show this first.
Can we show
all right.
that?
Can we show this? Okay, go ahead. Explain.
Okay, so this is what the sale of shares in Doctors Pharmaceutical Incorporated. Because I divested, one of the mode for divestment is to sell it so that you no longer become part owner, which I sold it. So ito na nakalagay, no? Tax clearance, this is June 2006.
Yeah.
So tax clearance, deed of sale of shares of stock, capital gains tax, tapos documentary. Lahat ng taxes binayaran namin, no?
Okay.
At saka yung deed of sale. I actually sold it to attorney Leonardo Siguion Reyna.
Okay.
Okay? Ayun yung mga shares of stock, 43,000 plus.
Okay, so
kompleto ako ng documents since 2006.
Just to clarify, in the SEC 2018 registration, so your brother serves as chairman, Cesar Duque, until today?
I think so,
okay.
Yes.
And your sister, who is a doctor, Dr. Luz, serves as president until today.
Yan ang hindi ko alam. Kasi hindi nga ako nakikialam eh. So I'll have to find out.
In 1996, when it opened, you served as director.
Yes.
And that only stopped in 2006.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
All right. So what you're saying is when GMA was president, you were appointed health secretary. There were no contracts that technically first your family's company had bidded for.
And that I was a member of the board.
No more.
Wala na ako. Okay. Hindi na ako. I already divested myself in 2006.
So, Lacson's allegations were in, there are two contracts.
More. Two more, sabi
two
niya.
More. Doctors Pharmaceuticals, it lasted 2015 to October 2017. I'm curious. When you were no longer health secretary, did they resume bidding with the DOH?
Yes, I think so.
Okay.
I think so.
So you were appointed by President Duterte again.
Yes. That was in October 26, 2017. But I swore in officially as Secretary of Health November 6, 2017. So I want to find out also the dates that are indicated in the PDI.
So is it
PDI.
Possible that maybe the family, I mean the corporation had closed contracts and you were unaware because you had sworn by November?
Yes, by November. That's right. Exactly. Exactly. That's a possibility.
Yeah, is
that's a possibility. But I have to verify that with the Doctors Pharmaceutical Incorporated director, Mila Villarba.
Okay.
Villarba.
So now that you have been health secretary for a few years, I would say maybe 2 years, is Doctors Pharmaceutical still bidding for DOH contracts?
Well, as per the record, ang alam ko, they had a deal with PITC. Pharma, or what is now known as the Philippine Pharmaceutical Procurement Incorporated, which is not under the DOH. This is under the DTI and PITC.
So it
but procuring arm, nagsusupply ng gamot ang PITC Pharma to DOH.
Yeah. And do you see that as a conflict of interest in any way?
No, I don't. Because number one, I'm divested. So how can I? How can there be conflict of interest? I divested.
But then what if Senator Lacson says, but in the end, it's still your family members running it. It's easy to divest on paper, but still you may end up having shares.
But that's that is pure conjecture and speculation.
Oo.
Kasi mahirap naman yung ganun. Basta sa akin, naayon sa batas. Di ba? Na you have to divest if you know there is conflict, there is a potential conflict of interest. And in this case, we already recognize there was going to be a potential, if not an outright conflict of interest, had I continued holding on to the shares of the DPI in 2006.
Okay, where is this coming from? I mean, you were already in private practice. You were quietly going on your way. The president asks you, please serve as health secretary again.
Yes.
You were already health secretary before you took the job. And then you have Senator Lacson on your case claiming that you are not as clean as you claim to be. Where is this coming from?
Well, I really don't know. It's wrong to speculate. So in my case, I will just have to answer all these allegations as factually as I can. Mm-mm.